So you have to be fruitful. First of all, give out something that is useful to nature. Give out something that is useful to the world. Then after you've given out that which is useful, at that time now, give us more like you. Praise the name of Jesus. If a human being is not fruitful, then we don't need more of unfruitfulness. So before we start reaching out and bringing people who are like us, we need to make sure that we are fruitful in ourselves, so that when we bring people to be like us, we are bringing forth people who are fruitful. Praise the name of Jesus. So you must learn first the concept and the principle of being fruitful. The principle of being fruitful. Because it is the principle that allows us to multiply. Praise the name of Jesus. The kingdom of God is not interested in barren people. So the Lord will never allow you to win souls if you are not fruitful. Praise the name of Jesus. One of the things that you can check if you are not able to win souls, so you're not able to multiply, it is possible that the Lord is not allowing you to multiply, because if you multiply to people who are like you, they're going to be trouble in the house of God. Praise the name of Jesus. If you give forth to more like you, they are going to be unfruitful. And God is interested in people who are fruitful. God is interested in people who can give forth fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. So fruitfulness is the very first principle that as a Christian we must understand, as a Christian we must come to comprehend that the very first thing and the very basic thing that a Christian requires is to be fruitful before you multiply. Praise the name of Jesus. So we need to be fruitful in ourselves. So God says, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue and have dominion. So for you to come to the place of dominion, you need to first of all be fruitful, then multiply, then replenish, then subdue. It is a process. You don't wake up in the morning and you are in dominion. You have to first of all be fruitful. Show us your fruit. Then after you see your fruit, then bring more who are like you, that is, you multiply. Then when the more like you come, you are able to bring them together, that is, replenishing and making them to scatter a blow to various areas. Then when they go to those places, they are also able to multiply more. So when you bring fruitful people, they are also going to give fruit. Now when that happens, there is replenishing. So we cannot be depleted. We are refilling. The easy word to use is to refill. We are refilling the earth. We are not diminishing. We are replenishing. Praise the name of Jesus. Then after that happens, it is when we are able now to subdue the earth and now have dominion over everything else. Praise the name of Jesus. People who are fruitful are people who are towards their dominion. People who are fruitful are respected. Because it says, and have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. So people who are fruitful, people who give fruit, are people who are in dominion, are people who are respected in all the spheres of life. Praise the name of Jesus. The president of Kenya today, if he goes airborne, if he is flying airborne in the soil of Kenya, that flight is called Air Force One. Praise the name of Jesus. So if he takes a certain altitude, all other flights that were using that altitude, they are diverted. Praise the name of Jesus. If let's say he's flying at 3,500 feet above sea level, if there was any other airline that was flying in that altitude, they are either taken higher or taken lower. You cannot fly at the same altitude with the president. When he is airborne, he is Air Force One. Praise the name of Jesus. When he was taking Madaraka Express, the normal name is Madaraka Express, But when he is in Madaraka Express, it becomes Madaraka 1. So if there was any other train that was supposed to use that rail, it is either postponed or diverted. Praise the name of Jesus. If he is traveling on land, the highway that he is using, if there was any other road user, they are first of all set aside. Praise the name of Jesus. If he goes to the sea, the same. The line in which he is traveling, there is no other equipment that is allowed to travel in that same area. Now that is because he is a person who to the nation is held respectful. Now as a Christian, if you become a fruitful Christian, the nature will not allow competition in your sphere. Praise the name of Jesus. There is nobody else who will be allowed to compete for atmosphere with you. Nobody else will be allowed to compete for space with you when you are fruitful, because fruitfulness will set you above. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. It is being fruitful that makes us to be set high above in the realms of the Spirit. It is being fruitful that gives us the opportunity to be high up in the spheres of life. Praise the name of Jesus. People whose businesses are fruitful are respected. Now in Kenya, we have a tax module that is called Pay As You Earn. Now, every person who is employed is under this taxation that is called Pay As You Earn. Now, the reason why most rich people will always have sagas with KRA is because they are not employed, so they don't pay tax. Praise the name of Jesus. The government actually encourages them to only maintain all their money in the system. If they were to withhold their finances, then there would be a financial crisis in the land. So they are exempted, quote unquote, they are exempted from tax so that they can take all their money into circulation in a bid to try and make more money. So as we are paying Pay As You Earn, those that are fruitful, they are given respect by the government such that their taxation is different. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. That is why you always hear them. They are taken to court because of non-compliance, but then the court has no fault on them. They are not getting paid. They are fruitful. When you are the one that is giving fruit, even the government respects. Praise the name of Jesus. So the Christian, we must come to the position of being fruitful. We must come to that position where we are fruitful. We are giving forth fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. We are giving forth fruit. When we give forth fruit, even the kingdom of darkness will not joke with us. Be fruitful. Praise the name of Jesus. Be fruitful. In the book of Galatians 3 verse 16, we find that the Bible compares a Christian to a seed. Of Galatians 3 verse number 16. Bible says, now to Abraham and his seed were the promises made. He does not say unto seeds as of many, but as of one, and unto your seed who is Christ. Praise the name of Jesus. So our Christian sphere is compared to seeds. And let me surprise you. You can count the amount of seed in a fruit, but you cannot count the amount of seed in another seed. Praise the name of Jesus. One seed, the one seed you see, has ability and potential to give many fruits and many seeds in the future. Praise the name of Jesus. So Christ was a seed of Abraham. Now the Christ who is the seed of Abraham now has given forth fruit that are called the Christians. And now because we are the Christian, therefore we are the many seeds that Christ has given forth. Praise the name of Jesus. So Christ is fruitful. Christ has multiplied. Therefore, we also need to be fruitful and multiply. A seed has many seeds. Praise the name of Jesus. Because a seed has potential to multiply. A seed is also the thing that carries the character of a tree. It is a seed that passes forward the DNA of a tree. Praise the name of Jesus. A mango tree will give a mango seed. In that seed is all the mangoness of a mango. Praise the name of Jesus. In that seed of a mango is all the mangoness of that mango. Because we are the seed of Christ. So our self, our nature should be able to show Christ. The fruit we give should bring Christ to be known. Hallelujah. We should be making sure that when we reach out, we are bringing forth people who carry the DNA of Jesus, which is the DNA we have. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A seed has the destiny of a tree. If all seeds are consumed, then the tree that was giving them becomes extinct. The destiny of a tree is carried in the seed of the tree. Hallelujah. The destiny of a tree is carried in the seed of the tree. If the seed becomes perverted, the future of the tree is lost. Praise the name of Jesus. The future of the tree becomes lost. So we need to come to the place where now the seed of Christ in us, we protect it with all ourselves. We guard the seed of Christ because the future of this tree called Christ lies in the seed called Christians. Hallelujah. It lies in a seed called Christians. And therefore we need to guard it. Now what we manifest, what we manifest is what has been given to us. What we bring forth is what we have received. Now you cannot give out what you don't have. Praise the name of Jesus. You can't give what you don't have. So that is why Christ ensured that before he tells you to be fruitful, he put potential of fruit. Before Christ tells you, be fruitful and multiply, he puts potential to give fruit in you. He gives us the potential first. He makes sure that we have the fruitness in ourselves. So when we manifest, what we are manifesting is the fruit that is in us. So Jesus says, how shall you know? How shall we know them? And he says, we shall know them by their fruit. We shall know them by their fruit. And Galatians 5 gives us a very good example that the fruit of the flesh is evident. Hallelujah. That is the book of Galatians 5:18. Let me just read it out here. From verse 18 it says, but if you are led by the Spirit, you are not under the law. Now the works of the flesh are evident, which are adultery, fornication, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry, sorcery, hatred, contention, jealousy, outburst of wrath, selfish ambition, dissensions, heresies, envy, murder, drunkenness, revelries, and the like, of which I tell you beforehand, just as I told you in the time past, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. So inheriting the kingdom of God is also tied to the kind of fruit we give. And then he continued to say, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such, there is no law. And those who are Christ have crucified the flesh with its passions and desires. Praise the name of Jesus. So to inherit the kingdom of God, we need to make sure that one, we are giving fruit and we are giving the right fruit. We are not only called to give fruits, but to give good fruits. Jesus says to his disciples, I have called you that you may give fruit and that your fruit may last. Praise the name of Jesus. Good fruits are lasting because good fruits have a seed that has goodness in them. Praise the name of Jesus. Good fruits, they give forth good seed. And so the good fruit lasts. Because we say the destiny is in a seed. So when we are giving fruit, we need to make sure that the fruit we give in that fruit is a seed that will carry forth the destiny. Praise the name of Jesus. We must ensure that the fruit that is being carried forward is a seed that has good fruit in it. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. What we manifest is a testimony of where we are and where we have been. Praise the name of Jesus. So whatever we allow in ourselves, whatever we allow to our heart, is what becomes manifest when we are showing forth fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. The Bible gives us a story in the book of Isaiah. And he's saying, I will sing a song to my beloved who had a good vineyard, planted good seed, but in the end got wild fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. So there is a vineyard that has good seed. This vineyard has been given good seed. There is everything good about the seed that has been given. So the seed has goodness in itself. But then the fruit it is giving a fruit that is not in line with the seed. Praise the name of Jesus. Now let me tell you something. The fact that Jesus has given you seed does not guarantee that you give fruit. Hallelujah. Now it is expected that we shall give fruit, but it is not guaranteed that we shall give fruit. There is much that comes to play apart from just the fact that we have received seed and we are able to produce fruit. And that is why, even when we give fruit ourselves, we must make sure that the fruit we give is the fruit that shall last. Praise the name of Jesus. The fruit has to last. The fruit has to last. The fruit has to last. Praise the name of the Lord. The fruit has to last. The fruit has to last. Jesus says in the book of John, chapter number 15, I am the true fruit. I am the true vine. And my Father is a vine dresser. Hallelujah. I am the true vine. And my Father is a vine dresser. Let me find these scriptures so that we can walk together. I am the true vine, and my Father is a vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. So there are principles that help us to be fruitful. Now I'm going to derive them from the book of John 15. The principles that help us to be fruitful. And one is that we must be sanctified. We must be sanctified. Now Jesus is holy. And therefore, as a Christian, we are called to holiness. Hallelujah. As our Lord is holy, so we are called to holiness. As our Father is holy, so we are called to holiness. And this is a fact. Another way he says, every branch that bears fruit, he prunes. So every branch that bears fruit, he makes sure that it remains sanctified so that it can give more fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. So God has to make sure that as we are giving fruit, the fruit is holy. And that's why he will prune us. He will prune us to make sure that we are having fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. So the principle number one of having fruit is holiness. We must be sanctified. We must be sanctified. He prunes every good branch. Number two is that for us to give fruit, we need to abide. Now where we read in John 15 verse 1, if we count the number of times Jesus repeats the words abide in me, it is very many times. That means abiding is something that we cannot do away with. Praise the name of Jesus. In verse 4 he says, abide in me and I in you. As a branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine. Neither can you unless you abide in me. We cannot bear fruit unless we abide in Christ. We cannot give forth fruit unless we abide in Christ. Abiding in Christ is a principle that will give us and bring us to being fruitful. Praise the name of Jesus. Abiding. We must abide for us to receive fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. Number three, we must allow ourselves to be moved by the Spirit. Now the fruit we are supposed to give are fruits that are in the spirit. The fruits that are expected of us are fruits that are in the spirit. So for us to give forth those fruit, then we must allow the work of the spirit to be done in us. To give the fruit, as we read in Galatians 5, the fruit that we can give, we can only give it as of the spirit, because it is the fruit of the spirit. Hallelujah. It is the fruit of the spirit. So we can only give it forth by the spirit. So unless we allow the Holy Ghost to take control of our lives, we shall not manifest the fruit that we are expected to manifest. Praise the name of Jesus. So we must allow the Spirit to take control of us, that we give fruit. Praise the name of Jesus. And number four, and this is where I'm going to conclude, is that the other principle of giving fruit is dwelling. Now, Matthew 25, verse 15. Allow me to read this. The book of Matthew 25, verse 15. The Bible gives us a story about people who were given a chance to multiply and to bring fruit. And to one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to another 1, each according to his own ability. So God does not expect us to give more than we can give. God does not demand of us more than our ability. God does not expect us to give more than what he has put ability in us. Now the good thing is, the ability that is in us has been given by God, and he is the same person who is coming back to us to ask for account. You can read down there, book of Matthew 25 from 15 downwards, and you realize that the one who was given 5 gave 5 and was commended. The one who was given 2 gave 2 more and was commended. That means the moment you produce fruit to your own ability, you are commended. There is no universal standard for bringing forth fruit. Fruit is according to ability. The ability you have is the ability that shall be measured with the fruit that you produce. Praise the name of Jesus. And Psalm 91 says, he who dwells in a sacred place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Him that dwells in the presence of the Almighty shall have the covering. So when the atmosphere is harsh, when the weather is harsh, when you are not able to bear fruit because of the environmental condition, then there will be a canopy that will come upon you because you dwell in the presence of the Father. Praise the name of Jesus. The environment should not dictate your fruit. The weather should not dictate your fruit. Because if you dwell in the presence of the Father, then the covering of the Father will give you a shade. You'll have a shadow that will give you a good covering. Therefore, the climate will not affect you. Praise the name of Jesus. People who are affected by climatic conditions are people who do not dwell in the presence of the Father. They are the ones who are affected by climatic conditions. Those who are visitors in the presence, they are affected by the weather. Those who are visitors in the presence of the Father are always affected by the climate that is around them. We should be changing the atmosphere, not the atmosphere changing us. Praise the name of the Lord. We should change the atmosphere, not be changed by the atmosphere. So we must abide. We have to abide. We have to dwell under the canopy. Now God counts failure to give seed or failure to be fruitful as being faithless. When we don't give fruit, we are counted to be faithless people. It is our fruit that measures our faithfulness. It is our fruit that measures our fruitfulness. So if we are not giving fruit, then we are counted to be faithless. And faithless people are not entertained in the kingdom of God. Moses breaks faith before God. He is told, you will see the promised land, but you will not enter. You will see it from afar, but you will not enter. So for us to enter into our promised land, into the God's promises upon our lives, we need to give forth fruit that we are counted to be faithful people. Let's stand up on our feet as we pray. Ability is given by God. I want us to just ask God to give us ability. I want us to ask God to give us the ability to bear fruit. I want us to ask God to give us the ability to bear fruit. To give us the ability to bear fruit. In Jesus' name. Just raise up your hand and tell God, give me the ability. Give me the ability that I may bear fruit. I want to bear fruit that is for you. I want to bear fruit that lasts. I want to bear fruit that lasts. I want to bear fruit and fruit that lasts. I want to bear fruit and I want to bear fruit that lasts in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I pray, my Father, that we shall bear fruit, that we shall bear fruit and we shall give fruit that lasts. Our fruit shall be found to be a lasting fruit. Our fruit shall be found to be a lasting fruit in the mighty name of Jesus, that we shall bear fruit and fruit that shall last. We shall stand the trial of time. We shall stand the trial of time. We shall stand even when the times are difficult. We shall be able to stand even when times and trial and temptation come our ways. Even when trials come our way, we shall stand faithful. We shall stand faithfully. We shall stand in the mighty name of Jesus. We shall stand in faithfulness. We shall stand in righteousness. We shall stand in line with your word. We shall stand, O God. We shall stand, O Father. We shall stand. We shall abide in you. We shall abide in you that we bear fruit. We shall abide. 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 We shall abide in the mighty name of Jesus. The Lord we shall bear fruit. Help us, my Father, to dwell in your presence. Help us 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 to dwell in your presence in the mighty name of Jesus. For them that dwell are the people who enjoy your covering. Those that dwell in your presence, they enjoy your covering. Them that dwell in your presence, they enjoy your covering. Them that dwell in your presence, they enjoy your covering. Them that dwell in your presence, they enjoy your covering. In the mighty name of Jesus, we bless your name and we give you glory. Receive all the praise, receive all the honor, for you are God, you alone. In Jesus' holy and mighty name, we pray and give thanks. Amen and amen and amen and amen. Have your seat. The Lord bless you and do you good. Our online viewers, we love you so much. We'll be coming to you live from the King's House, Muranga Town. The Lord bless you and do you good. Join us tomorrow. We shall be continuing with our lunch, our services. And the Lord is going to bless you and do you good in Jesus' holy and mighty name. Amen and amen. We appreciate you. And as we leave the online viewers, appreciate them in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord bless you from the King's House. We say, the Lord bless you and do you good. Amen and amen. And amen. Amen. Now, as you are in the King's House, I want us to give our offerings. I want us to give our offering.